letter from Apostle Paul. He confessed to one and all that the spirit's strong, but the flesh is all fluey. Things I should do, I don't. Things I say, I will, I won't. But my God's begun a work in me that'll one day be complete.
And I know I'm not the man that I ought to be. Many times I fall short of what you want in me. And I'm surely not the man I really ought to be. But thank God I'm not the man I used to be.
Just like Paul of old, I keep pressing toward the goal, forgetting all the things that lay behind. But instead I'll look ahead and I'll go where I'm led, toward the mark for the prize that will be mine.
And I know I'm not the man that I ought to be. Many times I fall short of what you want in me. And I'm surely not the man.
Traveling here in this life with its heartache, trouble, and strife. Sometimes Satan tries to tell me to turn aside. I say, Satan, get thee behind. No returning enemy you'll find. I'm too near my heavenly home where I'll abide.
I'm too near home to my Lord to receive
every word. I'm not returning to sin.
I have made my vow.
Friends and loved to wait will be worth whatever the cost to make it through. I would not give up in the race. I'll continue by the Lord's grace. I'm too near that wonderful home beyond the blue.
I'm too near home of my Lord to be
near home of every word. I'm not returning to sin.
I have
made my vow.
There's
nothing to go back to.
Oh,
praise the Lord,
God,
sweet heaven's in view.
I'm too near my heaven, my home,
and I'll return
now. I'm too near home to my Lord to be
near home,
heaven's reward.
thank you for coming tonight and making this a special night for the Cathedral Quartet. We are so thrilled to be here. Of course, when you get mine and Glenn's age, you're glad to be anywhere, you know? I was just thinking, before we left on this trip, Glenn's eyes had been bothering him. So he went to the eye doctor, and it was a Japanese eye doctor. And that doctor was looking at Glenn's eye, and he said, "You'll have a cataract." Glenn said, "No, no, I drive a Lincoln Continental."
Glenn, come here. He went,
driving. Yeah. I made that up. That didn't happen. I made that up. You know what? You know the Cathedral Quartet, most of you. So you're looking at and you just heard him sing. You're looking at a new face. I was going to sing a few songs before I really introduced this young. I can't wait for you to hear this young man sing. Ernie Haase is his name, and he's from Evansville, Indiana. 25 years old. I got socks older than that, you know.
I think he's got them on tonight.
No, I ain't got. You know, somebody was talking about my boots with this black suit, and I thought I had black boots on. I've had these black boots so long, they corroded on me. But I want you to listen. Ernie, the last few weeks, has blessed our heart with this song. This is an old song in fact, Marvin P. Dalton wrote this song.
Right.
And when was it, Glenn, he brought it to you?
1948.
1948, Marvin brought this song to Glenn on manuscript. And of course, that's nothing unusual. Glenn saw Amazing Grace on manuscript.
I like it.
Yeah.
Good, George.
Somebody asked me just before this program how old Glenn was. I said, when Glenn was a little boy, the Big Dipper was just a cut back in them. I'm doing good, ain't I, boy? I'm doing good. Let me let you listen to Ernie Haase sing a song. I'm going to take an old song, and maybe after he sings this song, maybe you'd like to welcome Ernie not only here but to the Cathedral Quartet. Listen as Ernie sings, "Oh, what a Savior."
He gave his life's blood for even me. Once I was straying in sin's dark valley, and no hope within could I see. Oh, but they searched through heaven and found a Savior to save a poor lost soul like me.
And then I'll join that. Calvary. On Calvary, his holy hands, they were nailed. Scarred his side was revealed. He gave his life's blood for a sinner. Said a sinner like me. Oh, what a Savior!
Ernie Haase.
I tell you what, since we're going to be here till 1 or 2 o'clock anyhow in the morning, tell you what, Ernie, come around and share a word of testimony, whatever you have on your heart tonight, and back up and sing that second verse for me. I'm about to have a spell over here.
I'm just amazed tonight at how God can be so good to one person in one lifetime as he has me.
Yeah, praise God.
I mean, so happy and so thrilled just to serve the Lord. I mean, I'm happier now when I'm not happy than when I was before I was saved, when I was considerably happy. You know what I'm saying?
I understand that, I think.
I'm just saying what I'm trying to say, folks, that the joy of the Lord is definitely your strength.
Yeah.
And I thank him for his love. I thank him for his joy. And even though it's unspeakable and full of glory, I thank the Lord that he says he has revealed it to us by his Spirit. I mean, I'm getting to do what I've always wanted to do. At the age of 15 years old, I prayed and asked God that someday let me sing with the Cathedral Quartet. 10 years later, here I am, living out a dream, singing with my favorite quartet across the country.
Oh, preach on, brother. I think he's getting good now.
Telling people about Jesus and then singing in front of people that are so kind and tender-hearted and loving as yourself. It amazes me to be able to do that. And it also amazes me tonight to be able to sing about a holy God. And I thank him for that opportunity. Death's chilling, chilling waters I'll soon be crossing. Oh, but his hand's gonna lead me safely.
Sinner like
God. You know what, Ernie? If I'd have been going to sing that song, I'd have sung it just like that right there. Ah, the young man thrills us. I tell you what, while we're doing old song, that's an old song. Glen Payne, on this new album, dug an old song out that he sang many years ago. And in fact, let me tell you this.
Now, you shared enough already.
His wife told me this just a few days ago, that they were, just before they went to bed, Van took a couple of pills, and Glenn said, "What are you taking them pills for?" And she said, "Well, they just seem to make me feel younger." And she went on to bed, and after she went to bed, Glenn just took the whole bottle. And the next morning, she woke up early, but Glenn wasn't in the bed, and she went to the kitchen where he was making coffee. He wasn't there, wasn't in the living room. She looked, and he was sitting out on the street on the curb. And she said, "Glenn, what are you doing out there?" He said, "Waiting on the school bus." So, I want you to listen to this. You know what, Glenn and I have been, if there's one thing that Glenn and I are asked as, in our travels, is how much longer are you two old men going to stay on the road? How much longer? Glenn's been out here 47 years. I've been out here soon 46 years. And people are asking, how much longer? And let me just say this. As long as God gives us the health and as long as we feel like we're doing what he wants us to do, we're going to keep on keeping on doing what we believe God called us to do. I tell you that. So, God has opened doors for us already that we never dreamed of, and we stand amazed at the doors God just keeps on opening. Seems like, well, here's a song that kind of says it, like we believe God is doing it for us because of him. We feel like we're just climbing higher and higher and won't come down. Here's an old song.
Listen. Once I was sinking in sin, my soul was troubled within. A ladder was sent down from heaven after my sins were forgiven. Started off a higher ground to climb the ladder round by round. Well, I'm climbing higher and higher and I won't come down.
The first round was regeneration.
Still climbing.
The second, justification.
Still climbing.
The third, a happy confession.
Still climbing.
And then the Holy Ghost took possession.
Still climbing.
The next round was great tribulation.
Still climbing.
Leads your soul to glorification.
Still climbing.
Well, I'm climbing higher and higher and I won't come down. I'm gonna climb till I pass the sun, moon, and stars. Jupiter, Venus, Neptune, and Mars. Farewell to this old house of clay, and then I'll go a running up the Milky White Way.
First to heaven,
I'm climbing round by round.
Second heaven,
I'm so high, yeah.
Oh Lord,
still climbing round by round. I'm climbing for higher ground. Well, 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 well.
I'm gonna climb till I pass the sun, moon, and stars, Jupiter, Venus, Neptune, and Mars. Farewell to this old house of clay,
and then I'll go running up the Milky Way right away.
First to heaven,
I'm climbing round by round.
Second heaven,
I'm so high I never come down. Still climbing round by round,
climbing
the higher ground.
Let it take you to heaven.
I'm climbing round by round.
Second heaven,
I'm so high I never come down. Still climbing round by round, climbing for higher.
Second heaven,
I'm so high I never
like to see old people get excited today. You know, while we're doing the older numbers on this new album we did, we dug that one out, and I'm glad that Glenn did. I love to hear him sing that song. There's groups going around now calling themselves rappers, don't they? Rap group. Glenn and I was watching the television the other day, flipped across, and there were some groups on there, and they got through, and they said, that's MC Hammer, a rap group, or something like that, you know. Glenn and I...
Was it Claw Hammer?
No, it wasn't Claw Hammer. They called themselves a rap group, and we realized that we've been rapping for years and didn't know it, you know. Back in the old days, they called that style of thing just talking something. In fact, the piano player would take off as fast as he could, and whoever had the lead tried to keep up with him. And we went and dug one. Some of you old timers are going to remember this one. It's called Let Out of Bondage.
God's children were slaves in Egypt's land, so God took Moses by the hand and said, Moses, tell old Pharaoh to set him free. But old Moses wanted a way to get out, cause in his mind he was beginning to doubt. He said, Lord, old Pharaoh ain't gonna listen to me. Well, the Lord said, son, throw down the rod. So Moses dipped and he cried to God, so they turned to a snake as evil and wicked as sin. Then he cried again with an awful wail, for the Lord said, seize him by the tail. And Moses did, and he turned to a rod again.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said, free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said, guide them, take them on their journey, and lead them to the promised land.
Well, Moses, Moses, I've got the power, and I'll be with you every hour. Go tell old Pharaoh to set my children free. Moses did, and the Lord helped out. He sent the plague to the land about, till old Pharaoh told him to go and let him be. Well, it started out with a cloud by day and a fire by night to lead the way, till old Pharaoh suddenly decided to change his mind. So he gathered together all his soldier bands and all the chariots throughout the land, said, I'll let those Israelites go some other time.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said he'd guide them and take them on their journey
and lead them to
the promised land.
Well, they came to the banks of the ocean blue. They turned to Moses and said, what'll we do? And old Moses fell on his knees there in the sand. Well, the Lord said, Moses, trust in God. Boy, the news raised up that rod. Over those mighty waters, stretch forth your hand. Moses followed the Lord's command, and the waters parted and vanished, and they saw a path led to the other shore. Well, the ground was dry and they passed on through, so Pharaoh's army thought they would too, but the waters fell. They ain't never been seen no more.
God promised to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He said he'd guide them and take them on their journey and lead them to the promised land. And lead them to the promised land.
Friend, and then you call me friend and laid down your life. I don't know if I understand love enough to die for a friend,
But Lord, give me love enough to lay my life on the line for you as I live. Help me to take risk, to reach out my hand, to open up my heart for those in my life for love of you. Lord, give me greater love.
What will you do for Jesus? He's done so much for you. He
gave that song to Mark Trammell a few months ago, and it's blessed us all. You know, I'm overwhelmed with God's touch upon my life. Most of you know that a couple of years ago, it looked like my traveling days and my singing days were over. I'm just going to do this briefly, but I promised God that I would tell about his touch everywhere I go, since he's touched me like he has. I had a heart attack with the guys in Denver, Colorado. The left side of my heart was supposedly gone. The catheter film showed. They sent me back to Cleveland Clinic in Cleveland, Ohio, to do the operation. And they were just going to patch me up and send me home. And the operation was 3 hours. Supposed to be 3 hours. It lasted 8 hours, and my lungs collapsed for the 8 hours. I lost my voice because I couldn't get my wind back. I lost my voice 4.5 months. People would ask me how I was doing, and I'd say, well, I think I'm getting along pretty good. I could talk about two words at a time. And when I did talk, I sounded like Ernie. I thought, Lord, if I get better, I'm going to be a tenor singer, you know. I confess to you, I didn't think I was going to get better. I couldn't hold a note a tenth of a second, had no voice whatsoever. And I'm not standing here tonight doing what I do with the guys that I love because George Younce had such great strength or stamina. Not because George was such a tough old boy that I tightened my belt up another notch and said, I'm going to whip this thing. I stand here tonight doing what I do because of a touch from the Master. Thank God for his touch. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven. Tableland, a higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. I'm pressing on the upward way, new heights I'm gaining every day, still praying as I'm onward bound. Let me sing that line again. Still praying as I'm onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, man. Yeah.
Praise God. Let me do a song from this new album. Bill Gaither and Mark Trammell, our baritone singer, produced this album. And we was over at Bill Gaither's house one night after we did it in his studios in Alexandria. And we went over one night after we were through St. Gloria, fixed supper for us. And we went over to eat. You ought to go by there and eat sometime. Tell them the cathedral sent you.
No, tell them George sent them.
But even though Gaither was involved in our album, he don't necessarily push his material to us, you know. But after we were eating, he had an old piece of sheet music laying on the coffee table. We picked it up, started reading it. We had one open spot, and we started reading the words of the song, and we said, Gaither, this is the very song we need to complete our album. And I want you to listen. Maybe some of you, I had forgotten about this song. It had been so long since I heard it. Maybe some of you are like me. But I am so glad we dug and brought out one of Gaither's older songs. And listen as we sing, I'm Free.
So long I have searched for life's enslaved by the world and my grief. Then the door of my prison was opened by love, for the ransom was paid. I was free. Set free.
Listen.
For when I met Jesus, He made me complete. He forgot the foolish man I used to be.
Whoa!
Oh,
You know what, Roger Bennett, since we're in a feeling like we have right now, we don't plan. We try our best to plan what we're going to do, but sometimes the Lord just leads, and this is not even on the program. We hadn't even talked about this, but there's a song that Roger plays. Most piano players wouldn't want to play a song like this because they would rather do the up-tempo stuff where they just run all over the piano. And but this special moment, all of a sudden, the Lord spoke to me. And I want Roger to do something that most piano players don't want to do. Do that softly and tenderly, Roger. I know this is putting you on the spot, but in the quiet of this moment, I believe the Holy Spirit's here. And do that softly and tenderly. Listen. Maybe let you listen to the old man sing another song. In fact, I keep picking on Glenn.
You sure do.
We were, just a few weeks ago, we were headed to Florida, and we had to go through Charlotte, North Carolina. And we were sitting up talking when we got to the city limits of Charlotte, and Glenn said, "Well, here we are in Charlotte." I said, "No, Glenn, you don't pronounce it Charlotte." He said, "Well, maybe it's Charlotte." I said, "No, I don't think I'm pronouncing it Charlotte." He said, "I've been through here a lot of times. You either pronounce it Charlotte or Charlotte." I said, "Glenn, I don't think you pronounce it either one of those." We went in to eat. The waitress come over. Glenn said, "Now, this is as slow and as plain as you can. What's the name of this place?" And she leaned over right in his face and said, "Burger King." That don't have nothing to do with this song. I just thought you ought to know that, you know. Here's a song that says, "Thus saith the Lord."
I am the worthy
fear not, for you are redeemed, and I have called you by my name. Make no mistake, evil can't take what's rightfully mine. So walk through the fire, wade through the flood, rise up in power, washed in the blood. Keep fighting on, I've already crossed your victory line.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, thus saith the Lord.
I'll pour my
spirit on flesh and unlock prison doors. I will go find the grace you need abundantly more. I am the very holy word, the saith the Lord.
It's not by might, neither by power, but by my spirit answers are found. When you believe that which you speak, I will pour out. If you say mountain, be thou removed, by faith it will crumble and come down for you. You will stand tall, conquering earth with a victory shout.
The saith the Lord of hosts, the saith the Lord,
the Almighty Lord. I'll pour my
spirit on flesh and unlock prison doors. I will go by the grace you need abundantly more.
I am the Word that parted the sea. The voice that spoke,
greater is he.
Spoke, greater is he.
I am the sword. Moses called the holy ground with a victorious shout that brought Jericho
down.
Ladies and gentlemen, everybody's already gone home here at Two Rivers, where we've done our video tonight. And we had a wonderful time, as you can see. But we talked it over, Roger, Mark, Glenn, Ernie, myself. There's a couple of songs that we didn't get on the video. And we just felt like we wanted to do something special for you folk at home. Mark Trammell sings a song that says, there are a lot of good books that'll make you anything from a lawyer to a gourmet cook. But my friend, I want to tell that when all else fails, why don't you try reading God's book? So we want to do these couple of songs, especially for you. Here's Mark to sing, read the book for you.
Some folks think that life is like a game and that nice guys finish last. Pay no attention to rules, they were made for fools. To get ahead, you gotta be real fast. But the big letdown is bound to come when you can't find peace of mind. the kind of peace that this old world gives. They need peace of a different kind.
God made the rules and he wrote them all down, and he gave them to all mankind. You can live your way, but sooner or later you'll pay if you try living over the line. There are a lot of good books that'll make you anything, from a lawyer to a gourmet cook. But my friend, I wanna tell that when all else fails, why don't you try reading God's book?
Oh, Martin, you're saying good, son. You know there's not a thing that we face in this life that's not covered in this blessed rule book. Tell it how we should live and how to win in the end. We just ought to take the time to look.
Why suffer the pain, mistakes we bring, when you try to play the game your way?
Whenever there's a doubt, check the rule book out. You need to see what it has to say.
God made the rules and he wrote them all down, and he gave them to all mankind. You can live your way, but sooner or later you'll pay if you try living over the line. There are a lot of good books that'll make you anything, from a lawyer to a gourmet cook. But my friend, I wanna tell that when all else fails, why don't you try reading God's book?
But my friend, I wanna tell that when all else fails, why don't you try reading God's book?
Well, God made the rules and he wrote them all down, and he gave them to all mankind. You can live your way, but sooner or later you pay. We try living over the line. There are a lot of good books that'll make you anything, from a lawyer to a gourmet cook. But my friend, I wanna tell that when all else fails, why don't you try reading God's book?
But my friend, I wanna tell that when all else fails,
why don't you try reading God's book?
That's a good song. I tell you what, Mark, you can take those kind of songs and sing them like nobody I've ever heard. I love that singing, buddy. I love it. There are a lot of good books. Let me say that line again. That'll make you anything, from a lawyer to a gourmet cook. But my friend, I want to tell that when all else fails, why don't you try reading God's book? If there's ever been a time we need to take that book and read it and apply it to our lives, it's this day and time. There's another psalm that we didn't get in the earlier part of our program. And this is unusual, I know, that we'd come back in. Everybody's gone, all the sets tore down and everything. But these two songs are so special to us, and we felt like we just didn't want to leave them off for you folk. So there's a song that Glenn and I have been out here, well, 47 years for Glenn, 46 for me. You've heard us mention that. I guess this is one of the most powerful songs to come along that we've ever heard. The song grabs me in the depths of my soul like no other song has in years. Here's a song that I hope blesses you like it touches all of us. It says, "Hallelujah, the Lamb has prevailed."
Angels stand in silence as they wait on heaven's border to witness what the Father would not see. Tears from their eyes fall as rain among the thunder as they watch the precious Lamb on Calvary.
Yeah.
His last breath is diminished. There's a shout of "It is finished." It's over now. They brush their tears away, returning to surround the throne. They gather round the Father as the hosts of heaven sing this song of praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
has been defeated. The enemy has failed. Alleluia, alleluia. Redemption is completed. The Lamb has prevailed.
Good singing, boys.
If I could climb a mountaintop, reaching high above the nations.
Yeah.
With my voice in a mighty melody. If the song could reach around the earth, get the world's attention, I would sing about the Lamb that set me free.
People are going to see us when they tune this video in. But I know that it's our prayer that people will look by us and see Jesus. So let's just ask him to take this video and bless it. Heavenly Father, as I said, we know that when the people put the video in, they're going to see us. But somehow, let your Holy Spirit touch those who watch it, and may they look by us and see the Jesus that we sing about. May he be lifted up. May he be glorified. May he be magnified, because that's why we spent all these hours here tonight. Amen and amen. So it's been a good night, boys. Mark, great job. Ernie, Roger, Glenn, it's been fun. This is Ernie's first video with us. And Ernie, we hope it's a lot more videos. You know, we, of course, Glenn and I don't know how many more videos we'll ever do. You know, we ain't got maybe many more left in us, you know.
But we're having fun.
Amen. But, you know, you guys will carry on in a wonderful manner. And so we've sung, we've prayed, we've had a wonderful time.
I say we go eat.
What's
that? I'm for that.
Well, I wish that catfish place is open. I'd love to go eat to that catfish. So it's been a good time, boys. I enjoyed it, man. I really did. One of the best ones we've ever had.
Great, guys.
So it's getting late. I know I shouldn't be eating this time of night.
You should.
I'm going to eat it. I wish I had a... Did they make a giant Big Mac?
It's called extra
whatever. Boy, that lady down the third row, I got so blessed tonight. It was all.